I'll accept. Alhamdulillah, we just finished Salat al-Fajr in the Jama'a. May Allah bless you all and accept from you. Ameen ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned too many ayat and is telling us the real life for anybody of us started since he died. What? Since he died? He died means khalas. People think he became dead and that's it. No, it's not like that. And I'm going to tell you, there is a last research I was reading from one of the universities here in New York. They prove that the human, their brain is still working after their death and they can listen to the people. Who said that? Non-Muslim people. This is exactly what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said before 1500 years, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After the Battle of Badr, you know, Abu Jahl, Udba, Shayba, Rabi'a, this kharbanin, you know, after their death and they've been killed, the Sahaba, they throw them in Qalib Badr. There is a well there and they throw them inside. And the Rasulullah was standing and they said, hey, Abu Jahl, hey, Udba, hey, Shayba, did you find what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised you? And Abu Bakr said, ya Rasulullah, you're talking to the demon. Are you talking to these people? They are not listening. He said, no. إنهم أسمع منكم ما أنتم بأسمع منهم. You're not listening better than them. Means they are listening better than you. Oh, and this is what American people saying in 2018. Last research in New York, I forget the name of the universities. And they make research for the dead people. They said موجات still موجات موجات they can receive, they can listen. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran. And Rasulullah said in the Hadith too. What the Quran said? He said, since you die, or the time of your death, قَلْ فَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ فَبَسَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ Surat Qaf. We take the veil away from your sight, and your sight became very sharp. Hadid, sharp. Just only your sight? No. I put in my tafsir, Nur al-Bayan, something extra, because I read a lot. They said, no, not just your sight. فَبَسَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ Your memory. Memory? Yes, in just a second, you're gonna remember everything like a movie in your life, like that. And that's why the mu'min will be happy and smile. You're gonna see a lot of good hasanat. Salat al-Fajr, like what you're doing. Reading Quran, sadaqah, charity, hajj. All of these good deeds will come in his mind, like this. I said, alhamdulillah. And the malaika of rahmah also, they're coming to them to give them glad tidings, and they deal with them in a nice way with the kafan of Jannah. And you see somebody who like, wallah, he was smiling. Yes, of course. He must smile. Subhanallah, I get the last view or last touch from the malaika before his death. And he get the smile. Subhanallah. Different person, different face. Different people, different malaika. Subhanallah. Again, remember his sins. That's why Allah said in the Holy Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ سُورَةُ فُصِّلَتْ Indeed, those who said our Lord is Allah, and then they stayed fast. They became the Sirat al-Mustaqim. Iman and Amal, righteous good deeds. During their time of death, Malaika will descend on them. What? Telling them, أَلَّا تَخَافْ Don't be afraid in your present time. وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا You're gonna remember a memory. According to the Quran, why I get it? Because it's good to explain ayah with ayah. This ayah explained the ayah in Surah Qaf. You're talking about the sight, but this ayah is not talking about only the sight. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا means in your present time. وَلَا تَحْزَن This now, this one. تَحْزَن about your past. When you remember your past, you see some sin, you'll be sad. And Malaika will say, don't worry about it. You're gonna leave your family and your business and your money and whatever you've been working for all of your life. And you're gonna be sad. How can I leave this? I say, wait, don't worry about it. You're going to something better. That's why I say, al-mawtu tuhfatu al-mu'min. Death is a unique gift for the mu'min. You've been waiting for this time. Don't be sad. You see this mashaykh in 1980s, I still remember them in Arab countries, Saudi and Egypt, when they stand in the minbar, والشجاع الأقرع يخرب بيت أم الشجاع الأقرع هذا نفسي أشوفه I said what's that what they call bald snake will come to you in your grave يا أخي ما طلعوا الشعر هيطلعوا الشعر عندك what is this all these mashayikh still, يعني they're sound in my ears. And they're making kufr to the people. Even Saudi Arabia's mashayikh. I used to get these tapes, I used to listen to them. Even you say, I heard some of them, they said, because you don't have beard, you're kafir. Wallahi al-azim. They said you're making four major sins. I still remember these sheikhs, you know, in Saudi Arabia. And some mashayikh in Egypt too, they're still alive, some of them. But may Allah get them. Now they are cooled down. Since it's like, it's not like this. You're talking to the human being, to somebody who has brain like you. You have to make dialogue, talk to somebody who has knowledge. You know, don't scream. You're screaming to the animals. What is this? And they think he's a good sheikh because he's screaming. It's not like that. No. You have to respect the people. You have to talk to them mind to mind, brain to brain. They have, Allah created this to understand. Yes, wallahi, but that's why we have to get out of this. Don't scream for what? Talk, open dialogue. Let people understand what you're saying. You're talking to somebody, maybe his intelligence more than you. Yes, he understands better than you. Why are you screaming?
It's no brain to brain.
Wallahi, doctor.
No brain to brain.
No brain to brain. What? Yes, sometimes when I stand in a minbar, I said, I'm sure somebody better than me, they are sitting here. I'm sure they understand maybe more than me. Don't belittle anybody. Don't think this, subhanAllah. Like what they say, subhanAllah, don't destroy the bridges. Why? Because maybe you need it back to come back. This is very important. So what happened is, subhanAllah, this ayat al-malaika will say, أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا. They give them glad tidings for Jannah too. For Rasulullah, let's go to the subject. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he was talking to these dead people after the Battle of Badr, Umar said, "Ya Rasulullah, they listen to you. They said they listen better than you." For the mayit will listen. And another hadith said that when you go to for the burial of somebody, you finish the janaza and you close the grave, everything. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, for those who've been following the janaza, "Al-mayitu yasma'u qar'an alihim." The mayit is listening to what? Their footsteps when they leave. Means he's listening. Wallahi, everybody's dying, he's listening to the doctor or to the one who announced his death. But he cannot talk because his body or his soul or whatever inside يعني, will be, خلاص, Allah said you cannot, he's not able to talk anymore. But he's listening better than anybody else. And they give you another proof too. Subhanallah, when you go to the cemetery or the graveyard, what do you have to say? Who knows? Assalamu alaikum. See, means you say salam alaikum to somebody's listening, but they cannot talk to you. Assalamu alaikum, dara qawmin mu'mineen. Peace upon you all mu'mineen, all believers, men and women. Antum as-sabiqoon, you came before us. Wa nahnu bikum al-lahiqoon, and we will follow you. Antum fartuna wa nahnu bil-athar. Yeah, antum for like if you have misfaha, antum fartuna, we are going to follow you. You're not, don't go away. So you're talking to somebody, but this somebody cannot answer you. But he knows whatever you're saying. That's why any dua or anything is going to them. Even I read some hadith when you visit somebody from your family in the grave, they are so happy and among the mu'mineen, I'm talking about the believers. They are so happy and they are proud from, with them. Oh, I get a visit from dunya. My son, some relatives, I get dua today. I get some gift today. Somebody makes charity in my behalf. Somebody makes istighfar for me. Subhanallah. I wala talih yad'u lahu, according to the hadith. By his son or daughter, they are making dua for him. My point today, subhanallah, whatever Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that is very strong proof among millions of proofs of his prophecy. He was a prophet, real prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he was talking about something from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He told Umar, they are listening. Abu Jahl, did you find what Allah promised you? Utbah, Shayba, Rabi'ah, we found what Allah did promise us. Did you find what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised? And Umar said, Ya Rasulullah, they listen to you. He said, they are listening more than you, better than you. Ma anta bi asma' minhum, subhanallah. So the point here is, we have to believe in that. The mayyit can listen, but he cannot talk. And that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, during the time of death of somebody, you have to have some kind of etiquettes. What kind of etiquettes? Very important thing, to sit beside him in a nice way, to laqin his shahada, to give him shahada, shahadat tawheed. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasul. How? As somebody's dying now, you're turning his face to the qibla, he's in his, khalas, in the process of death. Hey, say la ilaha illallah, you're gonna go to hellfire. Can we tell him that? Be careful. I know somebody died with cancer like you last week. Some people, they do that. When they go there, they joke, they make a lot of stuff. No, this is not the etiquette to talk to somebody who's going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First of all, put the Quran beside his head. Especially Surah Yasin. Rasulullah said, "Qara'u Yasin 'ala mawtakum," not after their death, before they die. Because Yasin talks about al-akhirah and this Jannah, the hellfire, and all of that will make him firm. Al-aqeedah, the creed, and all of that stuff. This one thing. Number two, don't tell him say la ilaha illallah. Maybe he will get mad and the man is sick or whatever, and he will say no, I will not say it, and he will die. You never know. Don't make him mad. Just sit down around him and just remember the name of Allah. Astaghfirullah, Allah. Alhamdulillah. May Allah give you shifa. Make dua for us. You're good, alhamdulillah. MashaAllah, your face a lot of nur in your face. There is no nur or anything, but just tell him that. You know, you know, just make him happy. Somehow give him some energy, you know? In nice way, in nice way. La ilaha illallah, astaghfirullah, alhamdulillah. And like this, mention the name of Allah around him, Allah will get him to say it, inshallah. Maybe somebody, he cannot talk, he will say it with his heart. Allah will accept it too. Allah is looking to your heart, not your tongue. So very important, inshallah, we understand from today, the mayyit can listen. And not just like what they said for hours, because what I read, they said for hours. No, not for hours. Mayyit can listen his grave until the day of judgment. Maybe later they will figure this out, because Rasulullah said that. Yeah, جزاكم الله خير. اللهم اغفر لنا ربنا وكفر عنا سيدنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا عافنا واهدنا واسترنا واجبرنا يا رب العالمين. نسألك خير هذا اليوم وخير ما فيه وخير ما بعده. ونعوذ بك من شر هذا اليوم وشر ما فيه وشر ما بعده يا رب العالمين. ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. صلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه.